I'm sure I'm like the 100th person to ask you, but since we have you, what are your thoughts on what went down last week and subsequently, you know, just how entertaining that was, but also just kind of how curious it was, the comments from both parties, and what were your thoughts on that?
Well, I've been monitoring kind of Nick Saban's comments on NIL for several months now, and with every public comment that he made, I could tell he was getting more and more frustrated. And I could tell the comments were increasing in his tone, his aggressiveness. It's kind of like a volcano rumbling, you know, spewing lava. And then the explosion happens, right? And that's the case with Nick with a lot of issues. And I think this was, one of those issues where he's frustrated at the current state of the recruiting landscape. However, I do think there's something else at play here that's probably been a little overshadowed. Nick was speaking to a group of business people in Birmingham, and like a lot of coaches in America, he's trying to get boosters and donors and the fan base to understand how important and how serious this NIL issue is, and that if you don't get in the game, so to speak, you may be left behind. So I think part of what he was doing was using Texas A&M and Deion Sanders and all this as a tool to ignite his own base and try to get them moving. And we're seeing that in a lot of schools. I was up at Ole Miss actually recently visiting with Lane Kiffin. And I'll have a Q&A with Lane that was very revealing tomorrow at SI.com. And one of the things he talked about was he's in the same position. He's trying to convince boosters that you got to play ball or you're going to get left behind.
Ross, with the SEC